Like, you could sneak into anywhere if you act like you belong there. Anywhere you want to go. It's all you got to do, right? You remember that couple that snuck into the White House? Yeah, they knew what they were doing. They got dressed saying, don't start nothing, won't be nothing. That's what they said. They went to the White House, had a $10,000 meal, got selfies with the president. And when they were caught, they're like, oh, this is not Olive Garden? And they left. I love horror movies. Anyone else? Yeah, they're great, aren't they? And it's not even the movie that scares you, really. It's afterwards that scares you. You know, that's the scariest part of a horror movie. Walking your car in the parking lot. That's the scariest part. You leave the theater, all the lights are flickering. You're just like, oh no. You just start skipping for no reason. You know, because you're just like, nope, they can't kill you if you skip. Nobody, you know, anybody sees you. Oh, he's too happy. Let's leave him alone. Everything's scary after a horror movie, right? Every other night, you're fine sleeping in your bed with your arms out, feet out. No problem, right? Just sitting there, right then. Not horror movie night. You got to tuck yourself in like a little burrito. You ever have to do that? Horror movie night, just tuck yourself in like a little burrito. Just make sure no arm is out. And then right before you go to bed, you always hear a noise. Something like, rrr, and you just lay flatter in the bed. You know, you just try to pretend you're another pillow. After 3 minutes, you finally get the guts to be like, hello? Now let me ask you this, what are you gonna do if something answers?
Good morning. It's Thursday, July 7th, 2022, and this is another edition of Cafe Devo, coming to you as we always do, almost live, from First Congregational Church, located here at the point of Saginaw and Washtenaw Streets in the heart of beautiful downtown Durand, Michigan. I'm Pastor Steve Wood. If you listen real close, you can hear the carrot gurgling away in the background. My coffee is on the way. My pal Bugsy is over there in the corner. Looks like he could use some of the coffee. Hey, before we get started with today's devotion, we want to send out birthday wishes to one of the men associated with our congregation. Hey, Brett Stahl, it's your birthday. Happy birthday to Brett. I hope you have a great day. We wish you all the best, and all together we say, happy birthday. We're continuing to read this morning from the book Truth for Life. It was written by Pastor Alistair Begg. It is copyright 2021, The Good Book Company. Genesis chapter 39, verses 6 through 8. Now Joseph was handsome in form and appearance. And after a time, his master's wife cast her eyes on Joseph and said, "Lie with me," but he refused. Temptation is an enticement to evil or sin. Everyone faces it. Even the Lord Jesus himself was tempted. In and of itself, therefore, temptation is not sin. It is our response to temptation that leads us either in the path of righteousness or down into the quicksand of disobedience. The actions of Potiphar's wife demonstrate how temptation expresses itself. Her approach was at first subtle. She began in her mind to look at Joseph differently. The eyes are a gateway into our souls and the path through which many temptations come. A lustful heart begins with lingering eyes. Her eyes having ensnared her soul, she lost any notion of modesty. How could she proceed to such a barefaced invitation to adultery? The answer is that she was clearly feeding lust at the level of her imagination, which is bound to increase the chances that we actually do what we've been thinking about. Sin is always ready to break forth in an instant, driven by blind, furious, and nearly irrepressible desires. There comes a point where we have gone so far down the road in our minds that all we need is the occasion. And so when the occasion arises, so does the outward sin. You and I can learn from the misdeeds of Potiphar's wife. Be sure that what you allow your eyes to look at and your mind to dwell on will sooner or later affect how you act. Temptations and the desires they awaken will be fed or they will be fought. Are we prepared to take every thought captive, as Paul wrote in 2 Corinthians 10? Instead of feeding lust or other sins, are we willing to enter the kingdom of God with one eye? Or is eternal life not worthy of such a price? What temptations do your eyes and your mind face today? While each is a dangerous invitation to sin, and they are all different for each of us, it also provides an opportunity to choose obedience. Pray for wisdom and boldness to recognize those moments and respond to those temptations in a manner that leads you in paths of righteousness. For more on the subject, check out Genesis chapter 4, verses 1 through 16. Father, we recognize today our weakness, and you are strong, and so we submit ourselves to you. We call out to you in the name of Christ and ask you for strength. We ask you to help us to flee from temptation whenever we find ourselves faced with it. Help us, Father, to do this so that we can walk closer to you and so we can bring you glory. Thank you, Lord, for your grace for the times that we fail, but may our grace not become license. Help us to walk in you, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, that's going to do it for us on this Thursday edition of Cafe Devo. Thanks for joining me. I hope it was a blessing to you. I'm Pastor Steve Wood. That's my pal Bugsy once again. And we both wish you a great day. Hope your Thursday goes well. God bless you, my friends. I'll see you tomorrow.